You look at it, and based on what the Browns have done in free agency, everybody says it's got to be an edge rusher at 26. What do you think?
You know, I keep thinking cornerback for whatever reason. I don't know why. I just keep thinking cornerback because, you know, we just spent the whole first segment of this show talking about, you know, the Browns meeting with Jadeveon Clowney and some free agent edge rushers they could look at. They signed Tack McKinley. And they haven't done a lot as far as outside corner is concerned. And that tells me one of two things. They're really content with Greedy Williams and they think he can be the guy. Or maybe they're leaving that open because there's some guys who could maybe fall down to them at 26 that they really like, some big physical corners that could kind of fit what they're looking for opposite of Denzel Ward. So that's one of those positions that I have circled, unless they're going to just shock us all and take a linebacker there at number 26. I just am circling cornerback as a potential option there, depending on who falls to the Browns at 26.
When you look at the fact that there's five quarterbacks that are likely to go in the first 10 or 15 picks, that helps the Browns. That means there's going to be some talented defensive players that drop down a little bit further into that first round. Take us through some of the guys that you think if the Browns have the opportunity to take at 26 or maybe even jump up a spot or two or three or four. They're not going to give up a lot to go get somebody, but they may give up, you know, a third or fourth rounder to move up a few spots. Who are some cornerbacks to listen out for?
You know, the big two to me are Patrick Surtain II and J.C. Horn. Now, I don't know if those guys are going to make it down there. And J.C. Horn had a great pro day the other day. And you see that 40 time that he runs, and it makes you think, I don't know if he's going to make it all the way down to number 26. But if he did, you know, if he starts falling a little bit, and I'm Andrew Berry, I'm getting in my car and I'm driving to Cleveland to make sure I'm standing next to Roger Goodell to make sure that I can turn that pick in and not miss out. J.C. Horn is a really good big corner, the type of guy you look for to maybe step in and start right away. And I think Surtain's kind of the same way. And then look, there's another guy. You know, Caleb Farley's an interesting guy because he missed his pro day because he's got to have a procedure on his back, and he opted out last year. And, you know, initially I thought there's no way he falls, but, you know, if maybe that back injury causes him to slide a little bit and the Browns aren't concerned about it, maybe you take a chance on him. But I would absolutely love it if a guy like J.C. Horn fell to the Browns at 26. That would be a no-brainer pick to me.
And you mentioned J.C. Horn and Patrick Surtain. Both of their fathers played in the NFL. So J.C. Horn is the son of Joe Horn, really good wide receiver. Patrick Surtain is the son of Patrick Surtain, who really good cornerback. So there's pretty good bloodlines there. How important do you think it is to get somebody as an insurance? I mean, Troy Hill can slide out, so you could do that. But you just never – anytime somebody says nerve issue to me like Greedy Williams, you always have to be concerned. You know, how long he's healthy now, will that be able to, you know, can he continue to stay on the field?
Yeah, you can't just say, yeah, for sure, Greedy Williams is going to go out there to start for the Browns. And look, they know more about this situation than anybody else. They saw him in their building rehabbing. They know where he's at. You know, they've gone through the testing and done all the checkups, and they'll know where he's at better than anyone. But again, you just don't know for certain how he's going to come back and play after missing a full year of football. And while you, like you said, Troy Hill can move outside if you need him to, but that's not what you signed him to do. So when you have to start moving guys around, it creates a chain reaction. So now you've got to find somebody else who can play the slot. And now you've got to find some depth behind that. We know that Denzel Ward misses games. So, you know, he's only played 12 games every season. He's never played a full season. You've got to kind of pencil in the fact that you might have to fill in for Denzel Ward a few games. So you've got to have depth at that position. You've got to have some guys that are content with not being starters, maybe. But then you also, if you can draft a guy, and maybe he's your guy there for the next 4 or 5 years, that's okay too. Competition is a good thing. You know, make Greedy come back and earn it. And if he doesn't, maybe he becomes that guy who is your depth. Maybe he becomes your Terrence Mitchell as a guy that can kind of sit back, play on the outside, and when you need him, you can have him there.
Now, without question, the Browns are going to draft some corners, and we've talked two that might work at that 26 spot. Who are a couple of names to listen out for maybe a little bit later in the draft if the Browns, you know, go edge rusher, or maybe they double up, you know, and they take it 26 and then they come back a little bit later? Andrew Berry has said you can't have enough corners.
Right. And one of the guys that I've kind of circled is Tate Allen. He's a guy from UCF who I think maybe he ends up down there a little ways to, maybe he ends up sitting there in the 50s and you can kind of grab him, you know, a good one-on-one guy. And I'm really looking at big guys. You know, I think opposite Denzel Ward, you want to have a big guy available to you to kind of go against the Chase Claypools and, guys like that who maybe cause problems for Denzel Ward a little bit. And so those are some of the guys that you're kind of looking at. And Tyson Campbell is really interesting as well. He's a bigger guy out of Georgia. And again, a lot of this just depends on how the draft falls. If you go edge rusher in that first round and some of these guys end up falling a little bit, it might be a little easier to use that extra third round pick to move up in the second round to get a guy. So those are a couple of the names in the second round that I'm looking at. And, you know, if they do go corner, there is an edge rusher I'm keeping an eye on. And I think Tim Bielik might've mentioned him on your show earlier this week. And that's Peyton Turner out of Houston. If they want to go edge rusher in the second round, but as far as cornerbacks, Tay Gowan, a guy that is really interesting to me. And so is Tyson Campbell.